Hello, everyone. Jose Rodriguez here. Some people who own the Pro 100 are wondering whether they can use this printer to produce prints for sale. Of course you can. Absolutely. It will produce excellent results even on some matte papers. By virtue of the fact that you're using a transparent dye inkset, and that new inkset for the Pro 100 is fantastic, as long as you stick with OEM. Now, the majority of you, of course, are going to jump over to a third-party ink source, and you've heard about that yellow gelling problem when you switch over to a water-based third-party yellow ink. And it's not just Precision Colors. It's any other ink, okay? As long as it's water-based, water and the new updated yellow ink from Canon for the Pro 100 don't like each other. In the correct conditions and dilution, you will get a gelling effect, and that will affect your printhead. You don't want to do that. You don't want to cause anything that will block your yellow channel in this case. And if you continue printing unaware of what's going on, you will literally burn out that channel and you need a new printhead, my friend. So be aware of that. Now, what can you do? So you shouldn't be using third-party inks if you're selling prints to someone. So what people have been kind of coming up with is to prepare two sets of cartridges, one with Precision Colors dye ink and one with OEM. So whenever they have to produce a print for money, they swap the whole OEM set and print. Well, let me give you a little bit information about what actually takes place when you perform such a swap. Anytime you switch, whether it's one cartridge or the complete set, you develop an ink purge. It's not a cleaning cycle. It's just a ink purge to make sure that if any air was introduced into the printhead, it is pushed out and you're ready to print. So you switch over to OEM. Well, you originally had Precision Colors or some other brand yellow ink in that printhead channel, and it should get pushed out. Then you're done with that job and you want to switch back to your lower cost printing system. And of course you remove the OEM set of cartridges, put them away until the next time they're needed, and you load up those that were filled with Precision Colors or other ink sets. And you continue printing happily. Now at some point, if the stars are aligned and the planets are aligned, and the pro clog gods are in agreement, you might get into a situation where you will develop that gelling problem. Why would you want to constantly expose your printhead to OEM yellow, back to PC yellow, back to OEM yellow, back to, you know, it's just Russian roulette. You don't want to do that. So if you plan, or at least if you know you're going to be producing prints for sale, here's what you can do. Make sure that you just always run OEM yellow. So you're going to need a supply of OEM yellow cartridges. Sorry, $15 each, but that is the only way you can ensure that your yellow channel will never, ever be exposed to the chance that the conditions will be just perfect to begin that yellowing or gelling process. Why would you want to do that? No, you don't. You don't want to do that. So if you're not selling anything and you're willing to just print with PC or whatever other inkset you're using, that's it. You're good to go. Once you have swapped all of the cartridges over to a third-party source, run a couple of cleaning cycles just to make sure that you have pushed out any ink. And by the way, never fill up the existing yellow cartridge OEM with the new ink while it still has yellow ink in that sponge. You may be fine, like I was, for about 2.5 refills, and bingo, it hit me. I was able to salvage the printhead with Windex, but most people will not be able to do that, because a lot of people will just ignore it and continue printing. Then all of a sudden, too late, realize that, oh my gosh, my prints all look magenta and cyan because you have no yellow printing. And that's what happened to me. I was able to catch it immediately and I stopped what I was doing, ran a nozzle check, bingo, that was the problem. I called Precision Colors. They said, yeah, we have seen that. And they told me what to do. So I was able to salvage the printhead. And so far, so good. It's been printing perfectly fine for 5 years. Same printhead, same printer, same internal ink pads, knock on wood. It should continue to give me perfect service for the next couple of more years. As insurance, I have a couple more printers in box unopened. Just today, I printed a beautiful, beautiful print on Palo Duro Soft Gloss using the Pro 100 and Precision Colors inks, and of course, a custom profile, and it turned out gorgeous. And I'm going to be sending this to one of my friends, and hopefully he will enjoy it a lot. Gettysburg, in fact, this whole scene no longer exists. So I was able to catch it before the Park Service completely cut down all those trees, trying to get the area to look the same way it did back in 1863. I disagree with it, but that's the way it is. So this is no longer there. Glad that I was able to document it before it went bye-bye. But you see what I mean? Pro 100 Precision Colors ink set, fantastic paper, produces fantastic results with a good profile. Anyway, so that is it. Remember, selling prints, OEM. If you're going to use the Pro 100, don't think about swapping ink sets back and forth. You're just asking for trouble, okay? You're spinning that roulette wheel. One of these days it's going to land on the wrong number. You're going to get a clogged yellow channel. So if you're going to be doing this a lot, there's nothing wrong with doing that, okay? But you have to take into account that that yellow can be problematic and it does not like water-based anything. So to prevent that problem from ever happening, you're going to have to use OEM yellow cartridges. That's your only way out. All right? Really, think about that, guys. All right, thank you so much. Don't forget to subscribe, share, and like. Happy printing, everybody, and bye-bye.